to address the issues facing Tennesseans today. From 10 News, this is Inside Tennessee.
Good morning and welcome to Inside Tennessee. I'm your moderator, John Becker. Our guest this morning helped make history yet again on the campus of University of Tennessee. Graduation inside Neyland Stadium. That is on a long list of firsts in this pandemic year, and we welcome back to the broadcast UTK Chancellor Dondi Plowman. She is almost notching her second year in that post, and Chancellor, it's great to have you with us. Also with us, our panel, Don Bosch, who's a Democrat and runs his own law firm. Susan Richardson-Williams is a lawyer, is not a lawyer, thank goodness. She does run her own PR firm, though.
She sometimes thinks she's a lawyer.
We don't need any more lawyers on this broadcast.
Chancellor, no more.
I want to just start off. Congratulations on the finish to the year. How would you use one or two words to sum it up?
Exhausting. How's that? It was exhausting and exhilarating almost every single day, to be honest with you. And capping it off with commencement this past weekend, I mean, I'm still not down from that high, to be honest with you. So, yeah, there's been a lot of firsts, a lot of hard work, and a lot of joy and celebration also.
And, Chancellor, one thing that caught my eye was that the UT campus had record enrollment last fall despite the pandemic. And as I understand it, this week you're on track to do the same and break another record this year. Is that true?
Yeah, I'm superstitious. Yes, our numbers are unbelievable this year. I'm not really surprised because I want to tell you something. All throughout this pandemic, we still had families coming to campus and taking visits, tours. They all had their masks on. They were in smaller groups, spaced out. And I got the feeling things were really rolling again. And so, yes, right now the numbers look great. It was historic last year. And we're headed, it looks like, for a great year. Now, a lot of effort has gone into that. We've got a great recruiting team. A lot of effort went in last summer. You know, we were scared students. We sent them home at spring break. We didn't know if they'd come back or not. So we're really excited, proud of this campus. I'm so proud of what we've done. And parents have told me again and again, boy, you know, I've got a child somewhere else, and I love the way you guys did it at Tennessee. I never really got to understand fully what that meant, what was happening somewhere else in other places in the country, but I feel good about where we landed, and we're excited about the fall.
I'm going to let Don and Susan in just a second. I want to get to two other foundational questions. Retention. Okay. The U.S. tends to have a lot of people drop out of college. In fact, we lead the world in that. Where does UT stand in college dropout rates? And what's the average time it takes the typical student now to earn a degree at UTK?
So retention is a term we use to describe the percentage of students who come back from the end of their freshman year, the spring semester, to the fall of their sophomore year. And our retention this past year was highest it's been, 88.5%. So that means we only lost 11.5% of the students between spring and summer, fall. So we were thrilled by that. We were even more excited that, think of this, during COVID, our retention from fall to spring, so fall of this past year when we're deep into COVID, we had 95% return rate in the spring. That was unheard of in times of no COVID. So our retention is getting better and better, and that's important because it is the key indicator of graduation rates. Now, the metric we use in this business is, what is your six-year graduation rate? That's every school in the country. That's the number. Ours is 71%. Now, that's still not good enough for us. We really want that to go up, and I can tell you that the percentage of students here, the majority of our students, 54% get their degrees in 4 years, but we want to see that four-year graduation rate go up. I'd rather see it at 74% and the six-year at 100%. So we've made a lot of progress, and we've put some programs in place that are helping with all of that, but it's a long haul, but it's important. It's very, very important for many reasons that all of y'all know.
Susan?
Yeah, Chancellor, first of all, thank you for everything you've done at the University of Tennessee. I think we're on the right road for progress, and you and Randy Boyd combination has been great for mine and Don's University. Let's talk a little bit about athletics. This is something Don and I also know a good bit about. He swam there. My husband was football captain there, and I worked there for several years with the Lady Vols. The governor just signed this week a bill that would allow student athletes to get paid by sponsors for the use of their likeness and their name. Is this something that we supported? And if so, why? What is the,
Right. So right now, the rules that the that we have had for students, athletes, have made it such that they couldn't, if they're on scholarship, they can't do anything else to earn money. So not only could they not sell their autograph, but they couldn't start a business. Like, let's say some undergraduate students get a crazy idea and want to start a little business, and they a t-shirt business, and they can do that. Student athletes aren't able to do that. So we have needed some modernizing of the NCAA rules about name, image, likeness. I very much support student athletes being able to benefit from their own image, their likeness. There are some things that in the SEC as a conference and most other conferences, we want to be careful about. We do not want, we don't want to open up the possibility of recruiting being affected by, well, if you go to this school, you can get paid a lot of money to represent this restaurant. And if you go to this school, you can get paid even more to represent this grocery store. I mean, it's got to be, we've got to have some boundaries for it. And frankly, that is what the NCAA right now is looking to federal legislation to help with, antitrust issues. So it's going to be complicated, but our student athletes need to be able to benefit, at least at a minimum, the same way that regular students can.
Just to note, that Donde, bill does pass, it's set to take effect in January 2022, and Don, I'll let you jump in.
Go ahead.
So I'm curious. I think back to the great Bad News Bears movies, where the baseball team was sponsored by a bonding company. Is the university going to have any ability to limit the types of businesses or the types of enterprises that a young woman or a young male athlete might be able to endorse?
Well, right now we don't have those boundaries, and that's essentially what senators and the House and the Senate are considering in Washington, actually, is a bill that would help give some sort of national standard about those kinds of things. Because otherwise, I have no problems with the bill here in Tennessee at all, but it's not the same as the bills in lots of other states from which we recruit students. So we need some sort of leveling of the playing ground. Now, you're absolutely right. Our bill in Tennessee goes into effect January of 2022. Florida's bill goes into effect July 2021. And that has become the date that people are concerned about, you know, and that we were hoping to get some legislation nationally by that time. So I don't know. We'll see what happens. But there's a lot of implications from it.
We're going to take a quick break on Inside Tennessee. We can pick up on this topic, and we'll certainly dive into others. Chancellor Plowman, our guest this morning. Stay with us.